20th appearance, first start for Oklahoma. Kylie Griffin digs in. And at exactly 1 minute after 11 a.m., Monticelli rocks, fires, brings it home. Misses low for ball one. How about that? Starting right on time. Thanks for joining us for the Sooner Softball Pregame Show presented by Walden Cleaners and Laundry. We owe you a lot that we haven't got to yet, including the starting lineup. As the 1-0 pitch, they're going to check with third to see if Griffin, the shortstop, went. She did, strike one. Sooner infield looks like this. The battery of Monticelli and Hansen. Sanders at first, Hodge at second, Jennings at short, Brito at third. Riley Boone is out and left with Jada in center and Cassidy Pickering in right. Ball slapped foul. Starting lineups, as always, are brought to you this year by Norman Regional Health. We'll bring you those Sooner starters. Starting lineup, I should say, as Oklahoma comes to the plate in the bottom of the first inning. We'll say Riley Ludlam in as the DP. Here's the 1-2. Popped up, left field, foul territory. Riley Boone gives chase, makes a catch. One quick out. Good start for Monticelli. So, weather has been an issue, and it's brought to you by the Trails Golf Club in Norman, where you'll experience everything you love about golf and more. Today is pleasant. No, still chilly. As a left-handed hitting, Tremere Harris digs in. Caught the inside corner, strike one. The current tip here in Lake Charles is 47 degrees, so it's ticking up. They're going to reach a high of 56 today. The 0-1 is a little bit low. One ball, one strike. The flag is gallant, beautiful, in the right center field, but lazily waving towards the right field line. Good to see. Here's the 1-1. Looped into left field and down for a hit. Harris slaps it the other way for the first hit for Central Arkansas. And for Peyton Monticelli in 4 1/3 in a Sooner uniform, just the second hit she's given up. So, as long as the wind stays down, this is a much more pleasant setting than anything we dealt with yesterday. And, of course, it helps that the sun is baking down on the turf here at Joe Miller Field, Cowgirl Stadium. First pitch is in for a strike to the first baseman, Morgan Nelson, a senior. Trails Golf Club in Norman, where you'll experience everything you love about golf and more. The 0-1 misses inside. Should probably go ahead and say thanks for joining us for the Sooner Softball Pregame Show, presented by Walden Cleaners and Laundry, where the difference is quality. Hope you caught our interview, an extended conversation pregame with Coach Patty Gasso. Speaking of Coach Gasso, she's jogged out to talk to the Sooner infield. As always, that chat with Coach is brought to you by Coca-Cola. Is Coke Zero the best Coke ever? Take a taste and find out for yourself. Well, what do we know about Central Arkansas? The Sooners run ruled them here on Friday in the opening game of the Cowgirl Challenge. I would like to apologize for the 800 times I've called it the Cowgirl Classic. They actually host four preseason tournaments here. One of them is a little bit closer to be non-conference season. Two Cowgirl Classics. This is the Cowgirl Challenge. Meeting's over. The 0-1 pitch, a little bit low and away, 1-1. How much more bearable is it today? Payne Monticelli, sure, she played at Wisconsin last year. She's out there in short sleeves. I don't know if it's quite that warm. Here's the 2-1. A little bit up, 3-1. But we were talking about the Central Arkansas Bears, led by their longtime head coach, who has a little Sooner tint to her. The 3-1 is a swing and a miss that almost looked like it just popped right out of the glove of Hansen. No movement yet. It's Jenny Parsons, who is the head coach for Central Arkansas. But first base, national champion Katie Self has joined their coaching staff this year. 3-2 pitch, pop foul, and it'll actually hit off the netting and rock it back towards the field. Hansen actually caught it down the first base line a bit. Outside of the addition of Katie Self, it has not been a fun trip to the Cowgirl Challenge for Central Arkansas. It hasn't been a good start to the season. Oh, the 3-2 misses low and away. Ball four. A frustrated Monticelli takes a walk to the back of the circle. That'll bring the left-handed hitting freshman left fielder Gracie St. Hilaire to the plate. Central Arkansas comes in 2-7 on the season, 1-3 on the weekend here. First pitch hit St. Hilaire, and Peyton Monticelli has loaded the bases here in the top of the first inning. And that'll bring Emma Veach to the plate. Central Arkansas opened up the Nice Cowgirl Challenge by beating Lamar 5-4. And then they've lost the next three games in run rule fashion. OU beat them 9-0. Lamar topped them 11-2. They played the early game yesterday, watched Oklahoma beat Lamar, and then got smoked by McNeese State here early evening yesterday, 14-0. So since their win, they've been outscored 34-2. But they've loaded the bases here in the top of the first inning for Veach. Emma Veach, the left-handed hitting right fielder, swings through, strike one. Our look at Central Arkansas and the opponent outlook brought to you by Polston Tax Resolution and Accounting. Tax problems don't care who you are, but we do. Pop up, Allen out of play, and quickly after the walk and a hit by pitch, Monticelli is ahead on Veach. No balls and two strikes. Here's the 0-2 from Monticelli. Up high, it actually popped out of the glove of Hansen, but not too far away. Today's Riverwind keys to the game are, well, I think you heard them from Coach Gasso if you were with us in the pregame show. Be all in, everybody. Hey, your check-ins today, all in. You're listening, all in. Here's the 1-2 from Monticelli. Hit pretty deep to center field. Coleman under it. Well, we have a play at the plate. She throws a strike. They've got a chance. Oh, my goodness. They got her. Jada Coleman, an absolute laser from center field. And a fly out. Throw him out. Double play to end the Central Arkansas threat in the first. How about all in? Riverwind Casino, keys to the game. Riverwind Casino, always a good time. Get to the Sooner starters when we come up scoreless, heading to the bottom of the first inning. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. I mean, Harris not even sliding there. Scoreless game, bottom of the first inning. Jada Coleman will lead it off. And the first pitch from Bailey Runner is high for a ball. Jen Rocha is coaching first base for the Sooners today, with Coach Patty Gasso over at third. Here's the 1-0. Inside, 2-0 to Jada Coleman. Here's a look at your starting lineups, brought to you, as always, by Norman Regional Health. Jada leads off in center. Alyssa Brito bats second, will play third. Riley Ludlam, the DP, in the three-hole. Tiari Jennings batting cleanup. Back in the cleanup spot at short. Here's the 2-0 pitch to Coleman. Good spot. Strike one, 2-1. Kinsey Hansen, catch and bat fifth. Riley Boone batting sixth in left field. Sydney Sanders will bat seventh and play first. Cassidy Pickering gets the start in right. She'll bat eighth. And Avery Hodge is making her fifth start of the season. 2-1. Ooh. Looked to be a little bit out. Called strike for our home plate umpire, Nikos Williams. Hayes Lesher is at first. Daryl Francis rounds out the umpiring crew. Standing down the third baseline, right on the, I want to say the cut of the outfield grass and the dirt, but it's all turf here, all of it. Here's the 2-2 to Jada. Lifted to shallow left field. Looking up is St. Hilaire, battling the sun and the wind. She makes the catch, and there's one away. Here comes Brito. Starting line is brought to you by Norman Regional Health, building our community stronger throughout South Central Oklahoma. Well, it took us long enough to get through all our pregame responsibilities. That's what happens when you have a good six-minute conversation with the coach. Here's Alyssa Brito. First pitch, a little I didn't mean to, check swing. They're going to say it's a fair ball. Brito thought that maybe it was foul, but it grounded right out in front of the circle. Runner gloved it, throws to first, and there's two away. That's the second time we've had kind of a weird play out in front of the plate like that. Yesterday, he had the strikeout where, after watching the replay, and some of you guys pointed it out on Twitter in the Lamar game, she struck out and it hit her, and then it rolled out in front of the plate. That was the 10th strikeout of the game. First pitch to Ludlam is all the way to the backstop. Kind of a frustrating start here for the Sooners all the way around. Load the bases, but get the big defensive play from Jada Coleman. And then quickly two outs here in the first. Scoreless game. Here's the 1-0 to Riley Ludlam. That's in for a strike. Riley Ludlam is our Love's Travel Stops player to watch. What a day yesterday for Ludlam in the opener against Lamar. She had the walk-off game-ending two-run single. She went 1-for-2 with two runs batted in that game. Here's the 1-1. Way up and away, 2-1. She then got the start as the DP in game two and went 2-for-3 with a run scored, a walk, and a run batted in. A great start to the season for the Furman transfer. Here's the 2-1 pitch to Ludlam. Popped up behind home plate. Is there room for the catcher, Fisher? There is. Love's Travel Stops. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. We are, I guess you can say, what? Less than 2 weeks away from the opener at Love's Field. It's 2 weeks from Friday. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Ludlam takes it high, ball three. There's work to be done. I think everyone is over the moon excited. I know that the crews are grinding to put the finishing touches on all the fan amenities and everything. I'm sure there'll be a work in progress, but everyone's focused on next week in Palm Springs. 3-2 is hard hit to short. Nice job staying down on it by Griffin, up and throws. And it's a 1-2-3 first for the Sooners. We head to the second. Oklahoma and Central Arkansas are scoreless. This is Sooner softball from Learfield.
at the bottom of the first. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on.
We head to the second. Oklahoma and Central Arkansas are scoreless. Back to work for Peyton Monticelli. She'll face Michael Wilson and Hood. That's Aaron Michael, Janaya Wilson, and Lily Hood. 6-7 and 8 hitters. First pitch is a little bit in, ball one. Shouts out to all the great Sooner fans that have made this trek to Lake Charles. They have experienced something you don't get very often in these early season tournaments, as Monticelli pounds the outside corner for a strike. Really battling the elements. I mean, Sed Coleman, man, he's like me. We're built for the cold weather. He's been here every pitch, seeing Charlene May, Cole's mom. Here's the 1-1 way outside. 2-1. This was, for many of those in the Houston area, a trip that was circled right away. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Checked her swing. Gotta say, it was up and in, ball three. This is not an area where Peyton Monticelli has struggled in her career control-wise. She's pretty solid. 3-1. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Good pitch. Had a walk and a hit batter in the first inning. I think she's going to become a fan favorite over the next 3 years. No doubt about it. She's got an awesome personality, this Peyton Monticelli. 3-2. Swing and a miss. Big fist pump from the circle from Monticelli. First strikeout of the game, and there's one away. Strikeouts brought to you by Tinker Federal Credit Union, Oklahoma's largest federal credit union. We'll bring Wilson to the plate. Janaya Wilson looking for her first hit of the season. In fact, this is, for Wilson, who takes strike one, her first start. She's made one plate appearance and walked so far in 2024. Here's the 0-1. Right on the outside corner, 0-2. See if Monticelli can get a quick second out as she rocks and fires with the 0-2. That's up and away, 1-2. Fun trip. Are you looking to add to the fun with a big win here today in a scoreless game in the second? 1-2, misses high. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Sooners will make the move back home after this game. Swing and a miss. Monticelli. Back-to-back K's here in the second. And there's two away. I said that wrong. The Sooners will head back to the hotel. After this game, the team flies out a little bit later on this afternoon. I believe it's around 6 o'clock. There is most of the staff who bust. That bus will head back immediately after the game. Two away, first pitch, swing and a miss for Lily Hood. I see you checking in. Kelly and Courtney Bryce tuned in Coweta. The 0-1 pitch misses low. Sooner Jill, talking about being in front of a fire, very, very jealous. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Called strike, a ball and two strikes. Sooner alum Karen Day has checked in. Karen gave me a great nickname for Riley Boone that I think we're going to try to use. Trey Linda Kerr's mom is turning 88 today. Happy birthday, Mama Kerr. The 1-2 misses outside all the way to the backstop. They're watching, tuned in for more. We'll hit all of them in the third inning. Let us know where you're listening from at OU on the air. That's at OU on the air. The 2-2 pitch. She turns and says it hit her and goes jogging down to first base. The home plate umpire seems to agree. Kinsey Hansen kind of turns and acknowledges to the bench, yeah, I just got her. So that's the second hit batter for Monticelli here today. The catcher, number 33, Kennedy Fisher. Jen Rocha realizes it and is going to go talk to her sophomore righty. Monticelli wants to get into journalism. We're having a little conversation about it earlier today. All right, earlier yesterday. Everything's running together from this weekend. Sharp kid, fun kid. Can't wait to watch her continue to grow as this season progresses. We are keeping eyes as well this afternoon on all of the softball they're trying to play out of the St. Pete Clearwater Classic. We'll keep you up to date on the games that are going on throughout with our scores brought to you by Air Comfort Solutions. And we'll also keep you up to date on all things OU baseball. What a win last night for the guys, beating Tennessee in extra innings. Bottom of the third out in Arlington right now. Sooners trail Nebraska 2-0. All right, meeting's over. Here's Kennedy Fisher. First pitch a little bit low, ball one. One ball, no strikes. Here's the pitch. Up high. Two balls, no strikes. Two outs, top of the second. Scoreless game between Arkansas and UCA. Here's the 2-0 pitch from Monticelli. That's in for a strike, 2-1. Though Hansen was set up outside. You see, she pointed back to Kinsey. Ball ended up finding the inside corner. Quick timeout from our first base. Allow the runner Hood to tie her shoes here. Hood, not really a threat to go, has not attempted a stolen base in her career. The 2-1 swing and a miss, strike two. Top of the lineup, Kylie Griffin waits on deck. Here's the 2-2 pitch from Monticelli. Got her swinging, inning over. Peyton Monticelli, in a roundabout way, strikes out the side, works around the two-out hit by pitch, and as we head to the bottom of the second inning, Oklahoma and UCA are scoreless. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Thank you, guys. I appreciate that. It was the most famous hair bun in all of Oklahoma. Here we go to the bottom of the second inning. Scoreless game. First pitch, T.R.A. Jennings grounds it down the third baseline. Diving play made, but no throw as Jennings will beat it out. First hit of the game on an infield single on a nice play by Watson. The third baseman took away what would have easily been extra bases, but the Sooners get a runner. Let's see what Canine can do. First pitch to the right-handed hitting Sooner catcher. Long looking runner now brings it home. It's a strike. I heard from the legendary softball journalist Tara Henry, because I hadn't pulled up D1 softball or any of the score sites at ESPN or anywhere. All the games canceled today down at St. Pete. Well, that ruins our scoreboard. Look out, Coach Gasso. 0-1 ripped foul. Peyton's down there, has his Sooner Vision camera too. He was doing a little. That might have got him. Oh, is Peyton okay? He's got good moves. Peyton can move over there. See y'all next week. Tara and her incredible crew at Palm Springs. Shift the softball capital of the world from St. Pete to Palm Springs. 0-2 to Hansen. That ball breaks well out of the zone. One ball and two strikes. Riley Boone waits on deck. What a weekend for Booney. Hansen in that 3-zip win over McNeese State went 0-3. Was 1-3 with a run scored and a run batted in. And the win over Lamar. Gets a piece of it to stay alive. Kind of mimics her swing with her hand. And that one might have taken a little bit out of Fisher. And he goes to Williams. He's going to walk the ball back to the circle to runner. Give her a chance to catch her breath here. So what do we have going on in the world of softball? We'll check the scoreboard in just a bit. We have this, a scoreless game in the bottom of the second. Oklahoma and UCA, Central Arkansas. Jennings aboard at first. Here's the 1-2 to Hansen. Grounded down the third baseline. Another amazing play by Wilson. Up throws across, but Hansen beats it out. And those were two sensational plays by Wilson down the line, where they both end up in an infield single. All Arkansas is already in action this morning in Tucson. They're in the bottom of the fifth inning. They lead Omaha 5-2. First pitch to Riley Boone. Shows bunt, pulls it back, takes a ball outside. Utah is already underway in Puerto Vallarta. They lead San Diego. You see San Diego. 1-0. 6-0. Top of the third, Virginia Tech leads Illinois State there in Tempe. Here's the 1-0 to Riley Boone. Try to chop at it. Can't get there. Strike one. Boone popped into the leadoff spot yesterday. The first game, she went 1-for-2 with a run batted in, and she just had bad luck in the second game, 0-for-4. The 1-1, she bunts this one foul. A ball and two strikes. Boone would have, could have, should have had a leadoff single against McNeese State yesterday, but she stumbled and fell coming out of the box. Turf monster got her. He's got two or three Sooners this week and got Kirsten Deal. And her 10th strikeout performance when she was trying to shovel a ball to first base. The 1-2 pitch with the runners at first and second. Boone grounds it back up the middle. Oh, it hits off the glove of the pitcher. Directs right to the second baseman who throws to first and gets Boone. Riley thought she beat it out. Jen Rocha, coaching over at first today, gave the safe sign. But Boone will head back to the dugout on a nice play by Hood as that ball shot right off the glove of runner and right to Hood. Jennings and Hansen move up to second and third, and here's Sid Sanders. Oh, she had a shot yesterday. Absolute bomb. First pitch is in for a strike. That was after a rarity. Sid Sanders wasn't in the starting lineup in the Sooner win over Lamar. She came in the nightcap and hit one out of the stadium. Now she rockets one in the center field, a base hit. Jennings scores. Here comes Hansen. She'll score. It's a two-run single from Sid Sanders to start the party here on a Sunday morning in Lake Charles, Louisiana. 2-0 Sooners. Sid Sanders now up to 3 runs batted in on the season. And here is the freshman, Cassidy Pickering, shakes her head as she takes the first pitch outside for ball one. There you go, Sid. That was an absolute bullet back up the middle. More of that. Here's the 1-0. A little outside, 2-0. Pickering at 389 on the season. Feel like we've seen the outfield rotation solidify itself a bit. Pickering has grabbed that job for now. And, of course, still lurking. The 2-0. Pickering takes the off speed. The drops in for strike one. But either Pickering or Boone will be in left or right. And Jada Coleman will be in center. Seems to be the early season plan here through the first 2 weeks. Here's the 2-1 to Pickering. Bounce to the right side. Waiting on it is the second baseman, Hood. Takes it off a second hop. Throws to first. And there's two away. Sanders advances to second. Here's Avery Hodge. For Hodge, nearly hit one out of here on Friday. Thought it was gone. First pitch, she lays down a bunt that goes foul. She ended up with her first triple of the season. 2-for-7 with 2 runs scored. That triple and an RBI. She bats with a runner at second here. 2 out, Sooners up 2-0. The 0-1. A little bit up. 1-1. One pitch to the left-handed hitting Hodge, headed home. Line drive, left field could be trouble, but reaching up and making the catch is St. Hilaire. Oh, that's the second ball that Hodge has scorched this weekend. That is right at an opposing team's outfielder. But the Sooners strike first. They put 2 on the board in the bottom of the second inning. And as we head to the third, it's Oklahoma 2, Central Arkansas nothing. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Oh, how's it going? Thank you. Well, Patty Gasso told us in the pregame show this is something we would see. S.J. Guerin coming out of the pin, the redshirt freshman, made her Oklahoma Sooner debut yesterday. Pitched 2/3 of an inning. In the original box score, they had given Guerin the win, but upon further review, they ended up giving Nicole May the win. Regardless, she looked great. See if she can get a couple of quick outs. Top of the lineup, Kyle Griffin, first pitch, right in for a strike. Guerin wears number 85. Big, deep breath. Stares in, rocks and fires. That's a really good spot for a ball low and away. So Peyton Monticelli, you would assume her day is done as we have our first Love's Travel Stops pitching change. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. Swing and a miss, strike two. But after some first inning adversity, Monticelli, 2 innings, 1 hit, a walk, 2 hit batters, and 3 strikeouts. That off speed dropped right off the table. Misses low, 1-2. One of Central Arkansas's assistant coaches was a little bit late getting out to the field. She's there now. Soft slap to third. Nice play by Brito. Throws across and gets the speedy Griffin. One away. Here's Tremere Harris. Sooner softball, as always, is presented by our OU Community Cornerstone partners, Fowler Auto Group, OG&E, OU Health, and Coca-Cola. University of Oklahoma Athletics is one with you. One out in the third for Tremere Harris. She has the only UCA hit. First pitch right on the outside corner from Gearin for strike one. Got a note from Tara Henry with a picture of the skies in St. Pete. Yeah, there's no way they could play. That was nasty. The 0-1, a little bit out, ball one. Luke Looper is checked in. Friend Caitlin Fournier is in the third inning shoutouts. Doug Hamilton in Hockley, Texas. 1-1 in for a strike. Strike two. Oh, great. Ryan Aber. The Oklahoman sending our man Aber out to Palm Springs this weekend. How about that? One ball, two strikes, the pitch. Oh, come on, man. Come on. You got to be kidding me. That was a beautiful pitch. I mean, the only place it could have missed was potentially a little bit low. But you got to give her that. Two balls and two strikes. Slap foul down the third baseline. I see Gayla Boone. And the Boone family is in the house. Oh, I've got to find the nickname that Karen Day had. All right, I got a little work to do to go searching through the mentions. Good question, Gayla. Two balls and two strikes. A little low. Full count. A lot going on today. With the rain. What am I saying? With the rain in St. Pete. A lot of eyes on this game. 3-2. Grounded off the foot. Sooners lead this game 2-0. We're in the top of the third inning, and that hit right off the foot of Tremere Harris, and it'll take her a while to get going. OU loves James and the crew at home in Stigler. Pat is in Kiefer. Sooner Amy in Tomball, Texas. DT is in Council Hill, Oklahoma. Kevin, Karen, and Coda checking in from Blanchard. That little session is over. The 3-2 pitch. There you go. Cold strike three. Two away. Well, is she going to get more than two hitters here today? Looks like she will. That'll bring Morgan Nelson to the plate. Margie writes, you'll be happy to know it's only 37 in Norman. When the sisters are listening, good week of weather to put the finishing touches on Love Field. Oh, can't wait. First pitch in for a strike. Larry in that St. Pete Sooner in. Judy down in Silver City, New Mexico. And you, wherever you're listening, let us know that pitch misses low. I had a lot of people tweeting about the dunk competition last night, so I'm having to work through that. The 1-1 is low and away. One ball, two strikes. We are off. Well, to Norman first, and then Palm Springs for one of the biggest events on the schedule, the 2-1. Good spot. In for a strike, two balls, two strikes. Mentioning, by the way, I finished this thought, Ryan Aber talking about the Oklahoman sending someone to cover this. I tell every fan that'll listen, this is the one event you want to go to. 2-2 is just dirty. I mean, absolutely unhittable off speed, swing and a miss. S.J. Guerin with two strikeouts in the third, and that'll set down a UCA in order. How about the career debut for S.J. Guerin? Five batters faced. Five outs, three strikeouts. We head to the bottom of the third inning, 2-0 Sooners. We'll tell you about the new Central Arkansas pitcher when we come back. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield. Ah, there it is. There you go.
Leading off the inning for the Sooners, the center fielder, number 24, Jada Coleman.
Oh, Jada, she's going to hit a home run before we come back from break, isn't she? I'm calling it. Here's the pitch. Thanks, Jada. First pitch at the bottom of the third inning is fouled off by Jada Coleman. 2-0 Sooners in the third. Here's the 0-1 headed home to Jada. Shows bunt, pulls it back, takes the ball. Well, I thought we were going to see a new pitcher. We are not. Bailey Runner back in the circle for her third inning of work. She's done a pretty good job, but this is the second time through the lineup for the Sooners. See what damage can start here with Jada, who flied out to left field her first time up. One ball, one strike. Rocks and fires. Grounds one to short. Deep in the hole for Griffin. Long throw. Say, Jada's fired up as she beat it out at first base. Leadoff hitter aboard for the second straight inning. Here's Alyssa Brito. I think Jen Rocha got us that call. Give all the credit to Coach Rocha making a rare appearance at first base as the first base coach today. Here's Brito. An odd out on a pitch that she didn't realize was considered a fair ball. Rolled out in front of the plate. And she was retired in the first inning. That's here with one on. Nobody out in the third, and there's a strike. Big game Boone. I'm going to use it a lot. Karen Day submitted that one. Big game Boone. Big game Booney. She seems to get it done in big moments. And a great start to the season. I like it. Here's the 0-1. Oh, Jennings had a cut. No balls and two strikes. Sydney was here and delivered a handwritten shout-out, which I appreciate, to Kate Cohen, who couldn't make the trip but is watching and listening in Long Beach, Mississippi. How dare you miss this, Kay? We miss you being here. 0-2 to Tiare is a laser in the left center field, up the alley and to the wall. Rounding second is Coleman. She'll round third. The throw is way high, not in time. Jada Coleman scores from first on an RBI double from T.R.A. Jennings, and it's 3-0 Sooners, or from Alyssa Brito. I tried to put T.R.A. at the plate a couple of times there. She scores Coleman easily from first. Here's Riley Ludlam. There might not be a hotter hitter to start this season than Alyssa Brito. That is her team-leading ninth run batted in, and her first double of the season. I don't know why the stats don't have her credited with a triple from yesterday. First pitch to Riley Ludlam is a check swing and called a strike. Brito had a triple yesterday. They don't have that on the stat sheet. There's no way it could have been ruled anything. There's no way they could have ruled that an error. No way. Here's the 0-1. Way inside. One ball, one strike. Keith came by. Philip in Houston came by. He said, you've got to try Daryl's sandwiches. You don't have a life outside of softball on the road. It's constant prep, man. Here's the 1-1. There's a line drive by Ludlam into left center field. Brito rounding third. The throw is cut off, and they'll leave it. And Brito will score easily. Riley Ludlam with an RBI single. Sooners bats coming to life in the third. It's 4-0 Sooners. How about this weekend for Riley Ludlam? And Central Arkansas will have what looks to be a pitching change here. No, maybe not. That was different. Almost as if there was just a simple message that Jenny Parsons wanted to send. And after she sent it, she walked back into the dugout. Sooners were anticipating, I think, a pitching change. Everyone kind of started to head over to talk to Coach Gasso. And at that point, Coach Parsons was already back in the dugout. All right, here is TRA, who I tried to give a double earlier this inning to. Sorry, Brito. First pitch, T.R.A. hammers one. Deep to center field, and it's out of here. A two-run home run to the deepest part of the field from T.R.A. And just like that, it's 6-0 Sooners in the bottom of the third inning. Home run number 4. On the season for T.R.A. What did Coach say in the pregame? Everybody all in. And after a bit of a sluggish start, boy, the Sooners got all in quick, and we're going to have a pitching change brought to you by Love's Travel Stops. Love's Travel Stops is the heart of the highway. So that would be home run number 77 in the career of T.R.A. Jennings. And as she chases second in career runs batted in, I believe with the two today, that'll be 7 runs batted in on the season. She's too shy. Lauren Chamberlain is second in career runs batted in for the Sooners with 254. With now, make sure I got my numbers right on TRA. They have her as, I feel like she has more than 5 runs batted in this season heading into today's game. But it's 7 runs batted in now. Double check that. Yep, that's right. So 7 runs batted in on the season. No, this isn't updated. Okay. She has 8 runs batted in on the season. So that means for T.R.A., I guess we were 1 game short on some of these stats. So with 8 on the season, she is tied with Lauren Chamberlain for 2nd all time. All right, base is empty. First pitch, swing and a miss from Kinsey Hansen. All that time, didn't get to tell you about the new Central Arkansas pitcher, as they'll bring in Julia Petty. She got the start against the Sooners on Thursday. Petty brings home the 0-1, kind of a fresh start here, and misses outside. So on the stats that they gave us, I thought there was a few things that seemed to be missing. They did not have the They did not have the numbers from last night's game. So one shy of Lauren Chamberlain. There we go. 1-1 is up high. I'm very perplexed by which numbers to go by. 6-2 more would have given her 8. So that means on her career, there we go. She's just shy. 2-1 pitch is low and in. Yep, she's one shy. All right. I was told there would be no math on the assignment today. 3 balls and a strike to Kinsey Hansen. Here it comes. Bounce down the third baseline. Another nice play by Wilson on the backhand. Long throw, and she got it. Hansen is retired. Here's Riley Boone. Big game Boone. That was a nice play by Wilson down the third baseline. Sooners have been peppering her all game long. Here's the first pitch to Boone. Pops it up left side, slicing towards the stands, and it'll get out. Victoria Nefis has a big group watching with her. Katie Heffling checking in from Strongsville, Ohio. Cat Dad says he's all in today. You better be. Jada's Uncle Chris is checking in from San Antonio. All of South Texas heard that cannon shot from Jada in the first. Bouncer right side. Really nice play at second by Hood. Takes a big hop. Throws to first, and there's two away. Here's Sid Sanders. Coach Flood has checked in. Andy Ritchie in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Why isn't the scoreboard working? It is working. Maybe the one on the video? I don't know. It's Sunday, man. Come on, Randy. You think anyone's working with us on Sunday? Ella Parker's going to pinch hit here. John and Robin, easy like Sunday morning, watching in Ada. In reality, though, thanks to all the crew over at SSP, Sooner Sports Properties, Sooner Vision for making this possible to be able to bring you this video feed. Thanks to McNeese State, you know, I was talking to them about the announcers and everything, and they have to share one truck with all of their different programs. They had a fight to get this game on this weekend. First pitch, Parker hammers one. No doubt about it. The deepest part of the field and out of here. I mean, an absolute laser. A bomb. A nuke. Might still be going. Holy smokes, Ella Parker. Make it 7-0 Sooners. We're knocking on the door of run rule territory. And there is something that Sooner fans better get ready to see a lot of in this young lady's career. Wow. All Harris could do in center field is turn and watch it go. First career home run for Ella Parker is an absolute rocket. Alina Torres will pinch hit here. How about the seventh spot in the Sooner lineup today? Sid Sanders, a two-run single in the second. Ella Parker. I mean, there's a facility. There's like a, almost like a little bit of a fancier shed beyond that center field wall. I think it cleared that shed. That was prodigious. Here's Alina Torres. Lena's been great coming off the bench and pinch hit rolls this season as that breaks in for a strike from Petty. Wow. Could hear the cheering in Los Angeles, California on that one. The 0-1, swing and a miss. Torres went chasing. Alina this weekend was 2-for-3 in the opener against Central Arkansas, but is 0 for her last four, including 0-for-2 in her start yesterday. She swings at this one in the eyes and fouls it straight back. Chelsea's checking in from Virginia Beach, the Kitches, and more. Stacy Rydell is in Arlington. Dr. Susan Walden in Norman. There's Miss Jane Jetson on a chilly day in Dallas. Angela and Doug are in Atlanta. Kendra and Toby are watching out in Arlington. Big group in Arlington. Mitch is in Owosso. Stan and Maggie listening in while trucking in North Alabama. All right, we're back to work. Back to action. 0-2 count here with two outs in the third. 7-0 Sooners. The pitch popped up. Right field. Shallow right field. Late break. But Veach is under it, makes a catch, and that'll do it for the Sooners. But the damage is done. A 5-run third, and Oklahoma has a 7-zip lead as we head to the fourth. Hopefully you're tuned in like Angie is in Fort Worth, Texas. Lonnie is listening in. Merle Washburn. Christina Bailey in Yale, Oklahoma. We'll hit more of the shout-outs as we roll on a Sunday in the Cowgirl Challenge, Oklahoma 7, UCAA nothing. As we head to the fourth, this is Sooner Softball from Learfield. That's pretty funny. Guys at North Road Creation, I just retweeted it. Sent us a picture with their dog that's just out watching the game. Alley Cat, good to see you. Can't wait to see everyone in the Jennings family next weekend. Mara Dickman is the Sooner athletic trainer. Good to see mom and dad are tuned in today. I will say it did sustain me when I heard some of the crew talking about their parents listening. Our bullpen catchers, Jocko, GR equipment guy. Appreciate you guys tuning in. Oh, yes, let's go. How about this? Back to work for S.J. Guerin. She'll get a second inning, and it'll be a much different look for the Sooners in the field as they've blown this game open in the top of the fourth inning. It's 7-0 Sooners, 7 runs on 8 hits. And an absolute bomb from both T.R.A. Jennings and Sid Sanders. I hope I did those shots justice because they were deep. Patty Gasso's going to run out. Coach is calling a timeout, and she's going to bring everyone together. See if we can make sure we've got the defense set. I mean, everyone. You don't see this very often at all, do we? She's brought the outfield in. She's brought the infield in. And she let Dekos Williams, our home plate umpire, know right away, hey, I'm talking to everybody. I'm calling a timeout. Sooner Softball is brought to you in part by the Trails Golf Club, the perfect atmosphere for great golf and family fun. At the Trails, you'll find golf at its best and social events to enjoy all year. Entertain clients, enjoy friends, make family memories. The Trails Golf Club, visit trailsgolf.com. Oklahoma Athletics would like to thank the official ePlay Stay partners. Visit Norman, Cup Bop, Courtyard by Marriott, Midway Deli, Nashbird, Norman NCED. Visit Soonersports.com for more information. and OG&E. At OG&E, we energize life. Nikos Williams is going to go out and talk to Coach. Coach is fired up, man. I love to see this. We had mentioned Jenny Finch being out here at a couple of these games this weekend. I mentioned how the Sooners had spent some time with Jenny Finch. They actually went to her house and had breakfast on Friday morning. How cool is that? All right, ready to start the inning. First pitch, S.J. Guerin pounds the zone for strike one to St. Hilaire, who was hit by a pitcher last time up. Here's that whole new look offense. Ella Parker at first, Avery Hodge at second, Jennings at short. Brito stays at third as that's fouled back. Riley Ludlam is in behind the plate. Pickering is moved to left. Coleman stays in center with Hannah Kaur now in right. Galen, this doesn't mean you can turn the game off. No balls and two strikes. The pitch reaches, grounds it back to S.J. Smooth. Throws to first. One away. This is really good to see. Here's Veach. But Jenny Finch is married to Casey Daigle, who was a first-round pick in the Major League Baseball draft, had a short pro career. But they had the Sooners out for breakfast to their home on Friday and heard it was awesome. Pop fly left field. Pickering makes the catch right on the left field line, and there's quickly two away. So how cool is that? How great is this for S.J.? Two away, 7-0 Sooners, top of the fourth, making quick work of Central Arkansas. Here's Michael. Aaron Michael. Let's see if we make it a quick 1-2-3 inning. First pitch, swing and a miss. I mean, S.J., when she wants to, when she takes something off it, it's as filthy as you'll see. Here's the 0-1. Ludlam did a great job of framing that, but pulled it back a little too far. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Strike two. The team appreciates this. You can see how fired up they are. They know SJ's been waiting and working hard for this opportunity. Here's the 1-2. Popped up right field. Hannah Kaur is there, makes the catch. S.J. Guerin points to right field. Her start to her career in the circle has been solid. She has faced eight batters. She's retired all eight of them, including a 1-2-3 top of the fourth. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning, 7-0 Sooners. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. What's up? It might be one of the farthest home runs I've seen hit. What's that?
Oh, it's so dangerous. I don't know. That was like hollow.
Yeah, that's true. It's not. It wasn't as deep as that, but it was deep.
Leading off the end for the Sooners,
7-0 Sooners. First pitch to Avery Hodge in the bottom of the fourth inning is outside from Petty for ball one. Tina Stanton's got us tuned in Glenwood, Iowa. Chili Bean has Iris tuned in to Claremore. Dogs watching softball will usually get you an automatic retweet, just saying. Here's the 1-0. A little bit low and away. Mark, Michelle, and Kai are watching from Blanchard. John and Jane in Casa Grande, Arizona. See you guys in Palm Springs next week. The King family is in Chakota. Here's the 2-0. A little bit out, ball three. A couple other quick ones here. Sooner in the G, listening in Muskogee. Todd and Denise in McLeod, Oklahoma, taking in the greatest show on dirt, now on turf. Zane and Jana checking in from North Huntington, Pennsylvania. Clarence is in Bartlesville. Here's the 3-0, ball four. I would say this has been a pretty good weekend for Avery Hodge. She reaches on the walk. And the Sooners have their leadoff hitter aboard for the third straight inning. Cabo, do you think I needed to explain prodigious? I learned it in middle school. I use it every now and then. First pitch outside to Jada for ball one. It's usually used in terms of home runs hit by names like Alo, Jennings. Boy, Hannah Sparks hit some bombs in batting practice back in the day. That Ella Parker home run was definitely prodigious. Here's the 1-0. There's a hard hit ball. Deep to left center field. It's got a chance. Oh, a sliding catch made out of nowhere by Hilaire on the warning track. And there's one away as Jada Coleman now 1-for-3 on the day after the flyout. That ball got knocked down by the wind. That ball went right up in the wind and got knocked down. Here Quincy Lilio is going to pinch it. Greg Goforth is eating and listening at the old plantation in Medicine Park. You ever been to Medicine Park? Anyone? It's awesome. Put it in your maps. Take a Saturday afternoon. Load up the Varsity Network app or the Franchise app. Listen to Sooner Softball and walk around. It's awesome. All right, here's Q Lilio. Quincy Lilio will check in. Avery Hodge on first. 7-0 Sooners. First pitch to Lilio. Stays up high, ball one. Last night for Q, she got the start in the 3-0 win over McNeese State. Went 0-for-2. We didn't see her in the 8-0 win over Lamar. Of course, that game finished pretty quick. Here's the 1-0. A little bit high, too. An hour and 45 minutes for game number one yesterday. OU and Lamar. Then the nightcap, just a tick over 2:30. Long game against McNeese State. The 2-0 hangs up high, ball three. Riley Ludlam waits on deck. Caleb's in Radon, Arkansas, Oklahoma, Frankfort, Kentucky for Ben. Russ and the crew watching from Memphis, Tennessee. Shout out Luke Blake and Victoria and Ephus and Edmond. Here's the 3-0 pitch to Q when it's in for a strike. Dodger Blaine will see you out next week in Palm Springs. And Todd and Shelley in the 314 in St. Louis. Thanks to everyone who's checked in, tuned in today. We appreciate you listening and watching Sooner Softball. Here's the 3-1. Ball four. So hitting for Alyssa Brito. Q Lilio walks. My man Ryan Rasnick has his dog Layla dialed in. Ludlam, one for two on the day, singled and scored a run. Was able to trot home on the home run by T.R.A. Jennings, who waits on deck. First pitch is a little bit out, ball one. You mentioned it's been good to see some familiar faces here this weekend. Katie Self, who is hitting coach for Central Arkansas. 1-0, way up high. I mean, there is flat-out frustration right now in the circle from Petty. After she threw that, she kind of threw her arms out in disbelief. She walks around the circle, gathers herself. The only out was a ball that might have been out of here on a normal day on a fly ball by Jada Coleman. Here's the 2-0. Ah, popped up. Looking up into the sun is the shortstop Griffin. Drifts under and makes a catch, and there's two away. Here's T.R.A. Jennings. Mentioned Allison Fanning, who had been the longtime video working in the equipment room, helping out Chase Brown. She's here this weekend. Bonus Sunday, though. I didn't think I'd get to see you today, so that's nice. T.R.A. Jennings is two for two with a single and a home run. She scored two runs as well. About a three-run shot here and then three quick outs in the fifth. All right, they're going to call the violation. There's the first timing violation that we've seen. Ball one. You've sensed that Petty was struggling a bit, and the home plate umpire said, you got to throw. Let's go. One ball, no strikes. The pitch. Jennings takes strike one. Well, he yelled violation. Pretty sure I heard him say that's a ball. Should be 1-1. There we go. One ball, one strike. First and second, two outs. 7-0 Sooners. Here's the 1-1. Check swing on a pitch way up. Did not go. This umpiring crew is, I don't know if they're any good, but they've been a joy to watch. There's some calls that they're right on. There's other calls that they'll kind of slow it. That third base umpire did there. Daryl Francis. Hard hit ball to short. This should do it for the Sooners in the fourth. High throw to first. They get Jennings. And after a couple of tough pitches, Petty does a good job of working around the two walks. And as we head to the fifth inning, Oklahoma in control. They lead Central Arkansas 7-0. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Oklahoma Athletics would like to thank the official Eat, Play, Stay partners, Visit Norman, Cup Bop, Courtyard by Marriott, Midway Deli, Nashburg, and Norman NCED. Visit Soonersports.com for more information. And MidFirst Bank is a premier partner of OU Athletics and your exclusive home for the OU debit and credit card. Visit MidFirst.com/Sooners for details. Member FDIC. All right, a couple of changes here for the Sooners. Back to work. for S.J. Guerin. Into center field goes Hanacore. Cassidy Pickering into left field. And for the first time this season, we see Maya Bland out in the field. Maya is out in right field. Battery remains the same of Guerin and Ludlam. SJ back to work. 7, 8, and 9 hitters. First pitch to Wilson, low and away, ball one. 7-0 Sooners, top of the fifth inning. 7 runs on 8 hits for Oklahoma. UCA Central Arkansas has just one hit. That came in the first inning. They loaded the bases in the 1-0 is in for a strike. Hannah Core walking around in center field. We've got a massive, massive logo in the center field of their turf. Cowgirl on a Bronco. A 1-1 pitch, a little bit in, 2-1. McNeese softball. Cowgirls been to the tournament 3 straight seasons. They've done a great job as the host. 2-1, a little bit up and away, ball three. They've got one more game today. There's a game after ours. McNeese will square off against Lamar. Here's the 3-1. Strike two. Good pitch. An infield of Ella Parker at first. Oh, Q's over at third. I didn't see that. Q Lilio is at third. T.R.A. Jennings at short. Hodge at second. A little soft humpback liner off a hop. Hodge gets it, throws quickly to first. And Wilson is retired. Just got over the glove of Guerin. Hodge stayed with a little bit of a funky hop and threw her out at first. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Take a taste. Find out for yourself. Coca-Cola official partner of the Oklahoma Sooners. One away. 7-0 Sooners. Here's Hood. Hit by a pitch in her only plate appearance back in the second, and S.J. Guerin continues to pound the zone. Entering her third inning of work, strike one. Here's the 0-1. I don't know where that missed. Ball one, but it sure was dirty. Guerin spinning it. That wind, that breeze, that cold air has subsided just slightly. There's a strike. 1-2. Q looks very comfortable over at third. Moving around. Haven't seen her in the hot corner during a regular season game. Played there some in the fall. See if she's tested. The 1-2 is lifted into left field. Pickering doesn't even have to move. Makes the catch, and there's two away. Here is Kennedy Fisher's spot, but it looks like we're going to have a pinch hitter for Central Arkansas. Emma Robertson. Like we saw Emma Robertson when OU played Central Arkansas in game one. Guess not. So Robertson will pinch hit here. And Patty Gasso has made her way out to the circle. She's coaching. I mean, it's 7-0. That's a lot of the future out there. Players that haven't seen a ton of time. I thought for a moment we might see a pitching change. Maybe we will. Yeah, we're going to see a pitching change here. Pitching changes brought to you by Love's Travel Stops. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. Kelly Maxwell will come in out of the pen with 2 outs. In the top of the fifth. Here, there to make sure she has the pitch call. And I don't know where you're watching from or listening from outside of those who have checked in, but we got to give a standing O to S.J. Guerin, man. How awesome was that? What a weekend for the redshirt freshman, mobbed by her teammates as she enters the Sooner dugout. She faces her first two collegiate hitters last night and gets two outs. And then here today, 2 2/3, strikes out two, doesn't allow a hit, and Kelly Maxwell will check in to take over. Now, trying to make sure I get all of my conversations with Coach straight. On Friday, when we talked about how did we end up here, Coach brought up Kelly Maxwell is from Friendswood, Texas. This is about as close as we could get to Friendswood. We're about 2 hours away. Seen her family. She's got a great group of friends here. She picked up the win in the first game against McNeese State on Friday night. Went five innings, scattering three hits, allowed one run, and struck out eight. That one run came in the first inning on a solo home run, and then she shut him down. She came in for an inning of relief last night, earned a save in the 3-0 win over McNeese State. And now she'll look to get what, I mean, as soon as she put a run on the board in the fifth, could be the final out of this game for Sooner pitching. 13 2/3 of an inning in a Sooner uniform. She's been fantastic. Five hits, just one earned run. 0.51 ERA. Here we go. First pitch a little bit up high to Robertson for ball one. She's looked really smooth, really comfortable. Obviously, the competition ratchets up next weekend. 1-0. Swing and a miss. Wow. Threw that right by her for strike one. Next week, Mississippi State, who has been off to a fantastic start. Late night doubleheader Friday night, Mississippi State and Wisconsin back to back. The 1-1 popped up foul and out of play. Sooners get San Diego State on Saturday. And the original schedule had Notre Dame on that Sunday. I know you will be playing Seattle on that Sunday, so there's any schedule that has still Notre Dame as that Sunday matchup, that's no longer the case due to some flight issues that they couldn't change. So the single game on Saturday against San Diego State, then a rare twofer on Sunday, including a very good Loyola Marymount team. The 1-2 up high. We'll clean that schedule up in the post-game show, but 7:30 Mississippi State Friday night, 10 o'clock Wisconsin Friday night, 2:30 Saturday afternoon San Diego State, and 11 a.m. and 1:30 for the Sunday doubleheader with Seattle and Loyola Marymount. 2-2, little low, ball three. We'll cut the ribbon and open Love's Field against Miami of Ohio on Friday, March 1st. I can't believe heading into the final full week of February already. Here's the 3-2 pitch. A little roller to the right side. Hodge gloves. Tosses to Parker, who retreated, got to the bag in time, and Kelly Maxwell makes quick work of Central Arkansas on the top of the fifth. We head to the bottom of the fifth inning. 7-0 Sooners. This is Oklahoma Sooner softball from Learfield. Another Sooner making their debut in one sense here. First plate appearance for Maya Bland in a Sooner uniform. Takes the first pitch outside for ball one. Here's the 1-0. Bland checked her swing but takes a strike. Maya Bland out of Argyle, Texas. An outstanding athlete. The number 11 player overall in the 2023 class. Here's the 1-1. Bland takes it outside 2-1. Maya with the Sooners on top 7-0 here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Has been the Reagan Rogers, the Riley Pogue, or Rayleigh Pogue, excuse me, Rayleigh. I'm sorry. How dare I do that to a Washington legend like that? 2-1. By that I mean she takes ball three. She's been the pinch runner off the bench. A role that Patty Gasso has usually tasked a young, smart, fast base runner with, and Bland has been in that role, but this is her first plate appearance of the regular season. Here's the 3-1. Ball four. That's the game-ending run. Hannah Kaur gets her first plate appearance of the day. Is looking for her first collegiate hit. First pitch, lines one foul. So far on the season, she's 0 for 6, but has scored a run . Here's the 0-1 pitch. A little bit up, 1-1. One ball, one strike. Nobody out. Sooners looking to walk this off. Pitch. Inside corner, strike two. Hannah Kaur had a hit in the Sooner uniform, but it's just been in fall ball. And she was amazing. Does have a run batted in this season. Her first career RBI, the 1-2, grounded foul. Ella Parker waits on deck. We mentioned how the Sooners had a trip out to Jenny Finch's home for a breakfast this week. And Jenny Finch sitting behind home plate taking this game in. It's a great relationship with Coach Gasso. Here's the 1-2 with Bland at first. Nobody out. Popped up foul and out of play. Don't count Kaur out of potentially finding herself in this outfield rotation. Once that bat gets going, which inevitably it will, look out. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Foul off the net. This game just rolls past the 1 hour and 35 minute mark, so we're at a good clip. Bland at first, Parker on deck. One ball, two strikes. Here's the pitch to Hannah Kaur. Line drive, left field, but right at St. Hilaire. Back to first goes Maya Bland, and there's one away. Here's Ella Parker. Heard from the man, the myth, the legend, Toby Baldwin. And want to remind everyone that you have chances to get tickets to see the Sooners play live on March 23rd and April 16th. Those two games, the Baylor and Tulsa game, will be played at Hall of Fame Stadium. Tickets are available at Soonersports.com. First pitch to Parker is outside ball one. Bland takes off and snags second base. Coach Gasso standing there with her chin kind of deep in her chest. Don't necessarily know if that was called, but puts Bland in scoring position. She stole a base, the 1-0. A little bit out. Ella Parker hit a bomb her last time up. Her first career home run. The seven hole tonight between Sanders and Parker is 2-for-2 with 3 runs batted in and a run scored. Not bad. Parker looking to end this one with one swing of the bat. Here's the 2-0. Inside, ball 3. I have said it, and I'm starting my campaign. I want the April 16th game on Tuesday against Tulsa to break the Texas attendance mark. Let's have two schools from Oklahoma have this mark, not an Oklahoma-Texas thing, huh? Why not? Here's the 3-0 pitch to Parker. She'll be taking here. Or not. Maybe it's not a 3-0 count. 3 balls and a strike. That's the only thing I can think of here. Let's coach. He said, just swing away. Let's go have some fun. Let's end this thing. Let's get on the bus, head back to the hotel, and get to the airport. But I do have it as a 3-1 count right now. Here's the pitch to Parker. Up high, ball 4. I was listening to the Oklahoma baseball win last night over Tennessee, listening to Josh Helmer, who did a great job on the call last night with Ross Hubbard, who was amazing. They had about a 5-minute review to get the count right in the ninth inning of that game. First pitch to Pickering is up high for a ball. Spot in the lineup is 0-for-2. Kind of think Pickering, if I'm doing my lineup right, I think she's the DP right now. Parker at first, Bland at second, freshman everywhere. The 1-0. Swing and a miss. Speaking of freshmen everywhere, this is the first trip that Nellie McEnroe Marinas has made. It's good to see her around the squad. She'll redshirt this season, most likely. Here's the 1-1 to Pickering. Outside, 2-1. Seven runs on 8 hits for the Sooners. Just 1 hit for Central Arkansas. It came in the first inning. Parker at first, Bland at second. Here comes the 2-1 pitch. Ball 3, way outside. Avery Hodge waits on deck. Sooner dugout still chanting away as they try to make number 62 yet another run rule win. Here's the 3-1. Pickering takes ball 4, bases loaded. Only 1 out. Anyway, if you want a chance to see the Sooners in person, go to Soonersports.com/tickets. Check on that Friday, March 23rd and April 16th game inside USA Softball Hall of Fame Stadium. One away. Here's Avery Hodge. Walked her last time up. First pitch. Outside, ball 1. Petty is just, she's in a rough spot trying to find the zone here. Central Arkansas stayed in the same hotel as we did. There were no standoffs or anything. They were a pleasant bunch. Here's the 1-0. That's in for a strike. She's trying to pepper that outside corner and finally gets the call. A ball and a strike. Bland at third, that's the winning run. Parker at second. Pickering at first. Freshman on the pond. The 1-1. Avery Hodge pops it up. Out of play. 1-2. Jada Coleman waits on deck. I'm okay with Avery Hodge just ending this right here. 1-2. Hodge digs in. Long look to the dugout from Petty. She's ready. The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Hodge reached for a pitch way out of the zone. And that is the first strikeout of a Sooner here today. Well, now two outs. There is a huge, huge hole up the middle. As the first pitch to Jada Coleman is up high, ball one. Coleman is 1-for-3. Singled and scored a run in the third. Flied out to left in the fourth. Also flied out to left in the first. Very weird 1-2-3 first inning for the Sooners. Here's the 1-0 to Jada. Up high, 2-0. Now she's got a hitter's count. By the way, quick baseball update. We mentioned that great win they had last night against Tennessee. Tough one today. They're in the sixth. OU baseball trails Nebraska 6-3 down in Arlington. 2-0 pitch to Jada Coleman. Ball three. These misses too, it's not like they're even close. And then she'll throw an excellent pitch right on the black. 3-0 pitch to Jada Coleman. Here it comes. Ball four, ball game. Jada Coleman, a bases loaded. Walk off, walk. And that'll be win number 62 in a row. The fake celebration in a roundabout way for taking a bases-loaded walk from Jada Coleman. High-fiving everyone, hugging everyone. Oklahoma sweeps through the Cowgirl Challenge. They've won 62 straight games, and in run rule fashion, they knock off Central Arkansas by a score of 8-0. The Bud Light postgame show is next. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield. We'll take it. All right,